Hi everyone, and welcome to this tutorial on the Flux Immersive channel. Today we're going to look at how to configure REAPER and SPAT Revolution using the local audio path mode in the context of a studio mix. SPAT Revolution is a suite composed of a standalone program and three plugins, SPAT Revolution Send, SPAT Revolution Return, and SPAT Revolution Room. The local audio path mode is the simplest way to connect SPAT and REAPER when running them from the same machine. This mode enables the exchange of audio and automation information between the two programs. In this example, we're going to mix a small session containing four instruments down to three different formats, binaural, 5.1 and 22.2. Let's begin with the settings that are specific to REAPER. First of all, we must make sure that the Disable Saving Full Plugin State option is not activated. This is its default state. Secondly, on each track that contains or will contain the SPAT Revolution plugin, we must enable the Prevent Anticipative FX option. Now let's go to the Preferences menu in SPAT Revolution. We must make sure that there are no audio drivers selected and that the sample rate and block size are the same as those in REAPER. Now let's come back to REAPER. We have here our instrument tracks in three different formats: mono, stereo, and LCR. First off, let's create our return buses, one stereo, one 5.1 and one 22.2. We must pay particular attention to the routing in REAPER. In fact, to avoid any problems of synchronization, the sends to SPAT Revolution must be treated before the returns, and to do this, we must respect the following schematic. Each send must be routed to each of the returns. You'll notice that beforehand, I took care to disable the send to the master of our source tracks. Also, remember to enable the Prevent Anticipative Effects option on the new tracks. Now let's add the send and return plugins. Configure the send plugin on the LCR track to 3 channels. Now configure the return plugin on the 5.1 track to 6 channels. And the plugin on the 22.2 track to 24 channels. Enable the local audio path mode on every example of the plugin by holding the control key when activating the option. We can now begin our routing in SPAT Revolution. Connect the inputs to the stereo output. The boxes in between are created automatically. Now we can switch the room to binaural, and if necessary, change the HRTF settings. To connect our 5.1 room, create the room and the master, then connect the sources and the return. Now let's do the same for the 22.2 room. Finally, don't forget to specify in SPAT Revolution that the format of our 3-channel send is LCR. Also, change the format of the mono sources to mono. Now let's check in REAPER that the audio is coming back to each of our returns. all the source parameters can be automated, like all plugins in Reaper. To do so, begin by going to Preferences, then the VST menu found under Plugins, and we want to configure Parameter Automation Notifications to Process All Notifications. Now I'd like to create an automation curve on the horizontal mic of the trombone, and to do so, I shall activate the right mode in Global Automation. Go to a room in SPAT, select my trombone, press play, and apply my automation. Reaper receives information regarding the source position in both AED and XY formats, so I shall disable the X and Y curves generated by Reaper. We can now check that our automation curve is being read back. Once we've finished our mix, we'll bounce it down in all three formats. To do that, we'll simply need to select our three return tracks, right-click, and select the option Render Tracks to Multi-Channel Stem Tracks. By default, the files will be generated in the root folder of the Reaper project. Thanks for watching this video. Feel free to subscribe if you like this kind of content, and don't forget to activate the bell to stay informed of any future content on the Flux channel. And if you have any questions, just write them in the comments below.